Ladies and gentlemen, boys and girls, I'm pumped. I'm very, very excited. I was pacing after I finished recording last time, because something just clicked in my mind. You remember the first chapter when Junko got killed? She said something along the lines of, "This wasn't supposed to happen." So she's involved in this plot in some capacity. And I know for a fact Junko comes back, because I saw a screenshot on Twitter, and I will forever blame that person and damn them to hell. But anyway, disregarding that. Okay, so Mukura was not part of that 15 in the prologue. That means she was controlling Monokuma up until chapter 5 when she got killed. Maybe that's the point when Junko took over, because all other 6 people can be accounted for because they were investigating, right? So I'm wondering how exactly Junko got possession of Monokuma when she was dead? I'm just gonna go in the trial, and hopefully answers will come.
Since this will be the final class trial, I've come up with a special rule.
Are you kidding me right now?
So listen up! If you can figure out Mukuro's killer and go on to solve the mystery of this school, you guys win!
What do we win?
But if you can't, then I win!
Great.
And of course, waiting for the loser is the super exciting, super heart-pounding punishment!
Are you saying that if you lose, you'll execute yourself?
Yep, sure will.
How daring.
And that's final? No loopholes? No wiggling out of it later?
Of course not! Bears never go back on their word!
Never mind all that. I just have one question for you.
Oh, you're taking this serious, huh? Are you feeling okay?
Is the mastermind only one person?
Hmm?
Don't bother. I already know the answer.
So going off my previous theory, Junko and Mukuro were part of the Ultimate Despair. Maybe they were the Ultimate Despair together.
You're all the mastermind, aren't you? You're all out to get me!
Oh, shut up.
I'm right, aren't I? I knew it!
Getting right into it, okay. I should expect this, honestly. Goop Proto places to check Headmaster Z handbook.
You guys have all been working together, haven't you? I have evidence, so I know I'm right!
Hey, you stole my line! You're all out to get me, I'm sure of it! I have evidence of my own!
What a coincidence! I too have evidence to present. Evidence that proves everyone other than me has been working together.
Oh!
What? Wait.
The photos!
On. This doesn't make any sense. How can the 3 of us each have that?
No, that's wrong! It's not just you 3. I have evidence too.
Okay, so the photos that Monokuma presented to each person had them cropped out of it and the remaining people placed in. So each person who got the photo, they weren't in the photo, it was everyone else. So that means that everyone else knows. I can't articulate it properly, I'm sorry. I'm just very excited.
What? You too?
The evidence you're all referring to is this group photo, right?
Well, yeah. Huh? Wait, but mine's different. With the picture you have, I'm in it. But that can't be right. Because in my picture... See? I'm the only one not in it.
Oh, wow. Let's take time to admire this picture for a bit. That's cute. I figured as much. In which case...
Hiro, you have a picture too, right? Let's see it.
Okay, but be careful with it. It's pretty important evidence.
This one too. It's just like I thought. Huh.
So the secret in these pictures has been revealed.
Junko's face has been obscured in each photo so far.
Secret or whatever, I don't care! You guys are all in on this together! That's why I'm the only one missing!
But you're in my picture! You're the ones trying to trick me!
So the whole purpose behind these photos was to get us questioning and fighting with each other.
How tricky.
The mastermind laid a trap to make us each think everyone else was working against us.
Huh? I laid a trap?
But that doesn't explain why both Hiro and Aoi are suspicious of Makoto. Or am I misinterpreting that and they're all just suspicious of everyone?
A trap? How rude! What grounds do you have for such audacious accusations?
The proof I need to reveal Monokuma's trap. Each photo has a certain something in common. There's a connection regarding what person isn't shown in the group photos. And that person is... the ones who got the photos. Wait, what?
I got it!
Yeah.
In each case, the only one not in the picture is the person who received it. So, in the picture I got, I'm the only one missing. In the picture Hina got, she's the only one missing.
Yeah, Junko's looking away, look at that!
And in the picture Hiro got, he's the only one missing.
I love Leon just like sliding in from the right. That's Chihiro. I love Chihiro. She's, I mean, he, damn it. Traps get me every time, I swear. He's so adorable. Look at him.
As long as we're talking about it, I suppose I should show you my photo as well.
Please do. The pool, eh?
In other words, Monokuma gave each of us a group photo in which that person wasn't included.
Is it just me or the sound's delayed?
And when we each saw our picture, you just assumed everyone else was the enemy?
Never mind, it seems scripted.
Figured it out, huh?
Yeah, I thought that must be it. But how was that a hint?
Each person has false memories implanted inside of them. Maybe? But you know, there might be more to this than just Monokuma trying to confuse us. There's something else that bothers me about everyone's pictures. What is it? What's digging at me?
Listen, can I see everyone's group photo one more time? It's not directly connected to what we're talking about, but I'd like to double check something.
Sure, no problem.
Yeah, I don't mind.
I'm sure there's something unusual about these group photos. What is it? I need to compare each of them one more time. Where's Junko? There she is, he's being splashed with water! Byakuya's- These are hilarious, I love them! Sakura's just doing the most ridiculous things and I love it! And look at Chihiro, she's listening! I mean, he... Hina's picture. Hiro's picture. I assume if you didn't know Junko comes back, then you wouldn't be able to easily spot this difference. Actually, you could, because it's very obvious. There's something strange about all of them. Something I can't quite pin down. Something... Oh, nice. Excellent.
Can you just forget about the photo already? Ugh. Trying to trick me with such an obviously fake photo? I'm still pissed about that.
And on top of that... they went to all that trouble to make it look like we were wearing matching uniforms.
Wait a minute. Toko and Genocide Jill. They retain fundamental information, but their memories don't. But they don't retain their memories. So that concept could be applied to everyone here.
Hmm? So you think they're fake? No. I assure you, they're quite real.
I believe you, dude.
What are you talking about? There's no way!
Yeah! I don't remember ever taking a picture like that, so it's gotta be a fake! I'm sure of it!
But you know, can we really be so sure?
How about the DVDs? Can I use that as a bullet?
Don't get me wrong, I don't remember taking this picture either. But is that really enough to be absolutely positive they're fake?
What do you mean?
The reason I don't remember this picture isn't necessarily because it's fake. There might be some other reason. Some terrible reason. An unbelievable but entirely horrifying reason. Oh, what? Amnesia. Damn it. Being too quick on the draw.
Now I understand. Let's say that somehow we'd all lost our memories. That could explain it, couldn't it?
Oh, I get it. So we all just lost our memories at the same time and forgot about the photo. Makes sense. As if. You expect me to believe such an unbelievable occult-type story?
Yeah! We all lost our memories? That's just... crazy!
It's only natural that they wouldn't believe it. But no matter how much they refuse, if that's the absolute truth, they have no choice. We can't move forward until they accept it. And there's another way to prove it besides those pictures. Is there? Enlighten me with the bullets. Monokuma control room interview DVD. Oh, what the hell? Ooh! I'm going with the DVD, I guess.
You're saying we all got spontaneous amnesia? Since when did this turn into some kind of sci-fi fantasy?
I promise you, I haven't lost my memory. Ever since I got to this school, I remember everything that's happened.
That was... Am I getting better at these, or are these getting easier?
Those photos aren't the only things that point to the possibility of memory loss. This DVD does the same thing.
You're not gonna show us something indecent, are you?
Toko, you're getting annoying. Please stop.
No, it's nothing like that. It's a video of all of us being interviewed by the Hope's Peak Academy headmaster.
When you say all of us, you mean...
I mean all of us. Including you.
You lie! I never did any kind of interview.
No, it's not a lie. Just watch the DVD and you'll see for yourself.
Yeah, Kyoko can back me up, as she has done from the past 5 trials.
The headmaster did, in fact, interview you.
What are you saying?
I didn't imagine you would remember.
It's not about whether or not I remember. You expect me to believe all this? That I lost my memory somehow?
Am I gonna have to fight you?
Well, we don't have any way to refute it, so we have no choice but to accept it as reality.
How can you say that? We're talking about living, breathing amnesia here!
I love how Monokuma was just in his pose the entire time.
To be honest, I have something else on my mind right now.
Something else?
You said the DVD contains recordings of us being interviewed by the headmaster, right? What were the interviews about?
The headmaster sat each of us down, one at a time, and asked us the same question. He asked us if we could accept the idea of spending the rest of our lives in this school.
Accept the idea, not necessarily the reality. The wording is important here, I have a feeling.
What kind of question is that?
And? How did we answer?
We'd say no, obviously.
Actually, we all said we could.
Well, you didn't see each and every interview.
Even me. I heard myself say yes. I could spend the rest of my life at this school.
Why? Why would you say yes to something like that?
I don't know. I don't remember a thing.
The same goes for everyone else. Nobody remembers. You don't remember choosing to live here forever, or even talking to the headmaster about it at all.
It doesn't matter if I remember or not. Even if I bought the whole amnesia thing, the idea that I would want to live here forever? That's just insane! How can I believe that?
Insane or not, we can't move forward until you accept it. Am I right?
Bullet time battle. Bullet time battle.
You sure are, cause it's all true!
Bada boom, there it is, no bullet time battle.
What?
I know it sounds absurd, but if it's the truth, there's nothing we can do about it.
Indeed. We only have one path in front of us.
Then, we really...
Yep, you all totally lost your memory at the same time!
I have a feeling it was induced, yes?
This is all making my head hurt.
And this isn't like some normal kind of memory loss. You stole those specific memories from us, didn't you?
Oopsie! You figured that part out too, huh?
You're having a gay old time, aren't you?
Of course. There's no way we would all just happen to get amnesia at the same time.
How could someone just steal our memories?
How? Come. That hardly matters right now. If I said it was hypnotism, would you believe me? Or we opened up your skulls and messed with your brains? Would you really believe anything I said? How it happened doesn't matter right now.
What matters is figuring out what memories you took from us. That's what you're trying to say, right?
I knew I could count on you.
The interview with the headmaster, taking that group photo, those can't be the only memories we lost. There must have been a purpose to it all. A reason for taking away our memories.
Of course there was a purpose. It all has to do with the original motive.
The original motive? Whose motive? The original motive.
You mean the motive you came up with to try and get us to all kill each other?
Oh yeah, if you kill someone, you get out.
That has something to do with the memories you stole from us?
It sure does. But that part's still a secret. Anyway, I'm sure it's not easy, but let's all focus on the class trial for the murder of Mukuro Ikusaba.
Okay, so you want us to figure out who killed her before we do anything else.
So until we do that, well, either way, we have to explain every last remaining mystery. So, the one who killed Mukuro, the true mastermind, that's what we need to expose. Control room, profile handbook. Okay.
So who did it? Who killed her?
Whoever did it is the same one who's behind everything. That much I'm sure of.
But when you think about it, is the mastermind really here in the school?
Of course! They have to be here somewhere.
What makes you so sure?
Does make me so sure.
Exactly. You're just making stuff up. There's no way the mastermind is here. The mastermind is probably a million.
No, it's wrong.
I swear I'm getting smarter. The last five trials, I, like, messed up so much.
There's no question that the mastermind is somewhere within the school.
How do you know? Did you find some evidence or something?
In the back of the data center? I found a panel that controls Monokuma. The mastermind must have been using that to control him all this time. So there can't be any doubt. The mastermind has been inside the school all along.
There can't be any doubt. In which case, there also can be no doubt that the mastermind is one of us.
Which gives more reason to suspect one another.
What? Why?
Recall what Makoto told us Monokuma said to him earlier.
Yep, 16. Yep.
So if the mastermind is in the school, we have to assume it can only be that 16th student.
But how'd they manage to survive all of this?
So we're the only ones here? It's not me! I'm not the mastermind!
Well, it's not me!
I blame Makoto!
Why do you blame me?
What?
Why me?
Cuz! It's super weird how you're the only one who survived being executed.
Oh, I get it. The only way he could have survived is if he was actually the mastermind himself, right?
Aw, nuts! You got me!
Wait! What are you trying to say?
Everyone, calm down. There's no reason to panic. The mastermind's true identity will become clear soon enough. Just as soon as we find out who killed Mukuro.
That's a good point. Rather than wasting time bickering, we should put our minds to work solving this mystery.
Yeah, well, how much time have we already spent talking about the murder?
He's right. What more is there to talk about?
If you want something to talk about, I think there might be one thing. We haven't fully established what Mukuro's fatal injury was.
And all of that is a blur because Makoto had that fever and we can't account for his actions.
Huh? But I thought we figured that out. She died when she got hit in the back of the head.
Which is where Kyoko's account comes into play.
No, that isn't actually what killed her. It was something entirely different. Wouldn't you agree, Makoto?
It was a stroke. She was trying to do a let's play of this game and died having a stroke trying to read the words. Yeah! Makuro's actual cause of death must have been the other wounds.
I got it! All of the wounds covering her body. That's what really killed her.
Hey, now hold on a second. You did read the Monokuma file, right?
So, did she have, like, hemophilia or what? Was it, I can't imagine what would be a damage over time type thing. I don't know. Body was covered with other wounds, but these were at least several days old.
It made it pretty clear. Those wounds were made at least a few days ago. So they can't possibly be what killed her.
Consider this. What if the murder itself took place at least a few days ago?
What?
What if, when we discovered her body, she'd already been dead for several days? If that's true, then naturally the wounds that killed her would appear to be however many days old.
That doesn't make any sense. Because she had all those wounds before she ever came here.
It's been more than a few days, hasn't it?
Huh? How do you know that?
Isn't it obvious? She was the ultimate soldier, right? So that means, you know...
But her profile says that she was completely spotless upon arriving.
You're wrong.
She denied me. Before I could even say anything.
Is there like a side room where you can go masturbate or something?
Come on. I mean, you think I'm not weird, okay? At least listen to what I have to say before you deny me!
Go on. If you're so sure we're gonna deny you, why bother saying it in the first place? Let's pull out the profile. There we go. Excellent.
Mukuro was the ultimate soldier. She must have been in 100 different battles. So, when you think about it, obviously, she got all those wounds in battle.
Are you finished?
You didn't deny me this time, Z-Mimesy. You made me go all cutesy.
Don't worry. There wasn't anything cute about it.
That's what makes it difficult. It's spinning.
Mukuro was the...
She must have been so... Obviously, she got all those wounds in battle.
Are you finished?
You didn't deny me.
Don't worry. There wasn't anything cute about it.
Mukuro was... She must have been a hunt, so... When you think about it... Obviously, she got all those wounds in the...
There we go.
No, that's wrong. No, Mukuro didn't suffer those wounds in battle. The file we found in the headmaster's room said as much. Despite the time she spent in battle after battle as a member of Fenrir, when she entered this school, she hadn't sustained a single injury.
To be denied so completely... Actually, it's kind of refreshing. Maybe it's because of all of Master's training!
Anyway, so we can be sure that Mukuro suffered all those wounds after coming to this school. In which case, they could be the very thing that killed her.
As a matter of fact, it's hard to imagine any other possibility. When examining her body, I found that her stomach and head wounds came after she was already dead.
Unless anyone has any better suggestions, I think we can say this with confidence. The wounds Mukuro sustained all over her body are what ultimately killed her.
Good. Awesome. Okay, what is this telling me? She had small little cuts all over her upper torso. How were these inflicted? How did they sustain for all that time?
But if that's what killed her, then does that mean she's really been dead for who knows how long?
That's exactly what it means. When we found her body in the garden, She'd already been dead for several days.
So then, what about the little matter of what happened last night? Makoto, you said you were attacked in your room by a masked assailant.
That was last night? I'm not sure on the timeline here. I thought it was nighttime when we were investigating, and then this is the day?
If Mukuro had already been dead for several days, certainly it couldn't have been her. So who was it that attacked you?
The identity of the one who attacked me, I can't think of anyone else.
I got it! The one who attacked me was the true mastermind. When we discovered Mukuro in the garden wearing the same mask, I naturally assumed she must have been the one who attacked me, but I was wrong.
That Monokuma insignia on the mask's forehead really bothers me for some reason.
It wasn't her at all. It was the mastermind.
What are you laughing at?
Oh, don't mind me. I'm just getting a little impatient sitting here listening. I think I'm gonna jump in.
Your contributions are as good as anybody else's.
Let's start off with a nice, easy question. Your assumption that I attacked Makoto is just that, right? An assumption. You can't really know who was under that mask, can you? I mean, that's the whole point of a mask. The true identity of the masked attacker is Mukuro Ikusaba. At least, that's what I think. Do you have any evidence that might convince me otherwise?
No, there's no way Mukuro is the one that attacked me. Even if I didn't see their face. Mukuro had a very obvious Fenrir tattoo. Comparing- Oh, her right hand is- Okay. Alrighty. How did I miss out on that detail for all this time? My god. It should be obvious. Oh.
You never saw their face, right? So you can't have any idea who was under that mask. I'm telling you now, it was Mukuro Ikusaba!
You're wrong. Even without seeing their face, there's another part of the attacker we can use to prove it wasn't her.
Oh? And what is this other part? Is it the right hand? Or the left hand? Maybe the right foot? Or perhaps the left foot?
This is amusing.
Or could it be the hips?
I like that layout there. I really like that layout. I love it.
You never saw it, so you can't have- I'm telling you now!
You're wrong. There's another part of the-
Oh? Is it the right hand?
Words can cut as deep as any blade, you know. 1 point deduction.
Shoot.
Alright, flashback time.
You never saw their face, so you can't have any idea who it- I'm telling you now, it was Mukuro Ikusaba!
You're wrong. There's another part of the-
Oh? Is it the right hand?
No, that's wrong! Mukuro had a tattoo on her right hand, if I remember correctly.
How would the mastermind overlook such a simple detail?
A representation of Fenrir. In other words, a wolf tattoo.
Why does she have those fake nails? That has irked me since chapter 5. What purpose do the fake nails serve? It can't be vanity. Like, come on.
But I saw the right hand of the person who attacked me. And there was no such tattoo. So there's no way the person behind the mask was Mukuro.
Yeah, well, okay. You got me. I guess it wasn't her. But that still doesn't prove that it was me. It could have been, you know, someone else, right?
Monokuma was getting flustered.
Hiro, Toko, Hina, and I all have solid alibis for that entire night.
Yeah! We were in the gym tearing you apart, so it couldn't have been any of us.
Oh, okay, sure. It couldn't have been any of you.
He's falling apart quite quickly.
But what about Kyoko? It totally could have been her! Uh-oh! No snappy comeback! Did I score a bullseye?
If you insist, I don't mind showing you.
Huh? Show me what?
What do you think? I'll show you the one thing that proves beyond a shadow of a doubt it wasn't me.
Makoto, you do it! Before anyone could say anything. Ooh. Kyoko was removing her gloves.
Your hands!
Without thinking, I let out a gasp. It was more than just a little burned skin.
Awful, isn't it? It happened when I was first learning to be a detective. I was inexperienced.
I thought you didn't want anyone to see those scars.
If it means we get another step closer to unmasking the mastermind, it doesn't really bother me.
Kyoko seemed to savor the words as she said them. Then she put her gloves back on.
My scars should suffice as proof.
You want to know how I got these scars?
Makoto, did the person who attacked you have scars like mine?
No, not at all. I'm positive.
Then this much has been made clear. There can be no doubt that the one who attacked Makoto is the true mastermind.
He looks utterly dejected.
This is just awful! On top of my secret being revealed, I had to look at those positively grotesque scars of yours! Sorry, did I say that out loud? I do hope I didn't hurt your feelings.
Not at all. You can say whatever you want.
I was born with thick skin.
Sure, as long as it means pushing me farther into the corner, right? But I'm not cornered just yet.
Cornered animals prove to be the most dangerous.
Because if you haven't noticed, the circumstances surrounding Mukuro's death are totally unknown.
That's true. All we know right now is she was killed a good while before this morning.
Oh boy, oh geez, I wasn't looking at the time. It seems we'll have to continue this trial in the next episode. Thank you very much for watching. That was Danganronpa Trigger Happy Havoc. It is available on Steam and the Vita for $30. The sequel, Goodbye Despair, is also available on Steam and the Vita for $30. Please pick them up if you can, because they are fantastic games. Thank you very much for watching. I will see you next time. Toodaloo!